Give me the phone and take the money. 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 Give me the phone and take the money.
All right, so that was the quick testing result. Now, let's jump into today's theme. WAN 2.2 Animate, KiJai Workflow, ComfyUI Setup for 8GB VRAM users. But before we go any further, let me drop down a little disclaimer. This content is AI generated and might contain errors or even things that make you uncomfortable. Please use it at your own risk and always double check with reliable sources. I'm not responsible for any consequences. The script you're hearing right now was written by me, but voiced by AI. The workflow itself uses AI, but the idea behind it is still human-made. So if you're allergic to AI, maybe click away before you get infected. Also, be warned, there's always a risk you might blow up your VRAM when trying stuff like this. I can't guarantee success. Now let's get into it. A lot of you have been saying the workflow is too simple and you want something more challenging. And my first reaction was, nope, because you'll end up with a headache trying to debug all of this. But since everyone keep asking, I'm bringing you something new, the workflow from KiJai. Hopefully you'll love it. It's still low VRAM friendly because this time I'm using Q3KS, which is actually lower than 8 GB. I know some of you saw the debate in the comments where people were saying 8.75 GB isn't workable on an 8 GB card. So this time I went even lower with a 7.97 GB model, the Q3KS GGUF model. I've uploaded it to my Hugging Face, so feel free to download it. Yes, Charlie Brown, I'm talking to you. Say hi to YouTube. This time, I'm making you proud because I've put everything in seconds since your math isn't quite there yet. Don't worry, I've got your back. So without further ado, let's dive into how to set all of this up. So first, we're going to start with downloading and loading the model. For the Q3KS model, you'll want to place it under this directory. ComfyUI models unet. For the base precision, I set it to FP16 fast with quantization disabled. And then for Sage Attention, you'll need to follow what I showed in my WAN 2.1 video, where I guided you through downloading Triton and getting everything set up. Now, I'll be honest, it's not the easiest thing to download, and I've repeated that many times already. If you want a simpler option, you can also follow Pixaroma's episode 55 tutorial. His explanation is honestly the easiest to follow, so I'll leave that choice up to you. Just to make it easy for you, there's no need to jump out of this video or disrupt the flow. I've included a copy of the WAN 2.1 cutscene on how I install Triton and Sage Attention at the end of the video. If you need it, you can skip to the end using the timestamp. Next, we will proceed to the WAN Video VA Loader node. Make sure you have downloaded WAN 2.1 VAE, which I've included on my Hugging Face, and place it in the ComfyUI models/VAE directory. I set the precision to FP16. For the Load Clip Vision node, make sure you have ClipVision H.SafeTensor downloaded, which I've also included on my Hugging Face, and place it in the ComfyUI models/clip directory. For the WAN Video LoRa Select Multi nodes, you'll need two LoRas. WAN Animate Relight LoRa and LightX2V, both of which I've included on my Hugging Face. Download them if needed and place them in the ComfyUI/models/LoRas directory. Last but not least, we move to the WAN Video Text Encode cached nodes. First, load the model named UMT5XXL int FP8Score E4M3FN.SafeTensors. The size is around 6.73 gigabytes, so it is safe for 8 GB VRAM users as well. You can also get it from my Hugging Face. Download it if needed and place it in the ComfyUI models text encode directory. I set the precision to BF16. After all these are loaded, we're ready to proceed to the next step, uploading the video and reference image. For the reference image, you can upload the image you want to swap into the original video. You don't need to touch the resize image node parameter, as by default, it should match the video size. You just have to make sure the uploaded image size and the uploaded video size are approximately the same to prevent distortion. For example, my reference image ratio is 2:3, and my uploaded video ratio is 16:9. To fit the video, the two sides of my reference image will be distorted, as shown here. If my character's face is located near the sides, then after swapping, the character's face will be distorted. I hope you understand what I mean. Otherwise, you can test it yourself. Upload your original video here and let the AI analyze it for character swapping. I assume you already know how to use the skip frame technique. The formula I always use is 4n plus 1, where n is equal to the frame rate per second, 4 is the video length in seconds, and 1 is the starting frame of the fifth second. I used this technique in my previous Hunyuan Video Foley project to generate AI sound effects and stitch audio together seamlessly every 3 seconds. It's not that hard to understand, is it? For now, just make sure you edit the video down to around 3 to 5 seconds before uploading it. Otherwise, ComfyUI may crash. Don't say I didn't warn you. Below that, there is a built-in masking model tool called Segment Anything 2. It's integrated, and if you run it for the first time, it will automatically download the selected model for you. To use the point editor later on, you must run it once. Go to the end of the video generation node, bypass them, and then run. You will then see the first video frame appear in the point editor. A green circle marks the area that needs to be masked. A red circle marks the area that should not be masked. Use shift left click to add a green circle and shift right click to add a red circle. I suggest not adding too many because it's hard to delete them afterward. You can delete a circle by pressing shift, but sometimes it doesn't work as expected. You will also see the masking result by default, and you don't need to change the default settings, just leave them alone. Below that is the face detection node, which works somewhat like infinite talk lip sync. You get the idea. Someone once asked me to make a video about it, but I refused because it requires more VRAM. This time, however, you can achieve a similar result using the WAN 2.2 Animate GGUF model. So before we activate the bypass node again and run the workflow, I'll explain some of the node parameters you can adjust before generating the video. WAN Video Block Swap is an amazing tool that can swap VRAM usage to RAM. When using this, you need to make sure your RAM is large enough to handle video generation. It is a good option for users with low GPU VRAM. Other than changing the number of blocks to swap, you don't need to touch anything else. For the WAN Video Text Encoded Cache node, there are positive prompt and negative prompt inputs. Usually, you don't need to change them, but if the video doesn't generate what you want, you can adjust the prompt. For example, in my project, the AI couldn't detect the money in the hand, so I simply added the prompt, "The man is holding money," and it was detected perfectly. For the WAN video sampler, I adjusted the steps and CFG, but the results were really poor, so I left it as default. You can experiment with it if you want. For the WAN video animate embeds, the default value is 77, but I changed it to 81. It's up to you whether you want to change it or not. At last, let's talk about the results for each GGUF model and the FP8 model and compare them.
Give me the phone and take the money. 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 Give me the phone and take the money.
Here's the generated video result. If you want only the generated video, connect the Get Image Size and Count node directly to the Video Combine node, and there you go. I recommend using the Q3KS GGUF model because it's not only faster than the Q6K GGUF, but the quality is almost the same. Do not use the FP8 model. While the quality increases slightly, the render time is much longer. Trust me, it's not worth it. Also, expect longer generation times. I'm using an RTX 5090, so your render times will likely be even longer. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I've stitched the Triton and Sage attention part at the end of the video. See you in the next one.
First, back up your Python embedded before doing this, because there's a chance it will corrupt your environment. For Triton, copy as path python.exe file, go cmd, control V to paste it, and type this. You can download 3.3.0, but I choose version 3.31 because I'm using 50 series GPU. To check your Python version, you are supposed to open cmd and type py --version. It should show your Python version. In my case, I thought I was using Python 3.13, but it was actually 3.12. If you are downloading the wrong Sage attention view later, you will get an error like view is not a supported view on this platform, so be careful. To check your PyTorch and CUDA versions, open cmd again and type pip list / find string torch. As you can see, my PyTorch version is 2.8 and CUDA is 12.8. For Sage attention 2.2, you must have CUDA 12.8 and PyTorch version 2.7 or above. To uninstall PyTorch, use this command. To install a new PyTorch version, type python -m, then paste the appropriate installation command from the official PyTorch website. We need to download CUDA toolkit 12.8. Go to the previous versions page, select your operating system, and download the installer. After installing it, search for View Advanced System Settings. Under the Advanced tab, click on Environment Variables. In the Environment Variables, check that your CUDA path points to version 12.8. If not, double-click the variable to edit it. Make sure the path for CUDA 12.8 is listed above any older version by using the Move Up button, especially if you have multiple versions installed. Now go to the WildMinder website, the link is in the description. Choose the correct version and download Sage Attention 2.2. Open cmd, paste the path to your Python exe file, and use it to install the Sage Attention view you just downloaded. And that's it, the installation is complete.